Hello, welcome to Universe Mode episode.
Shit.
268, week 60, 76, something like that. Friday Night SmackDown. Pay no attention to Randy Orton's somewhat feministical walk. God, I can't even remember the own card. I can't even remember the own card you booked as well.
Be right back.
Short-term memory all over the place with this one, but here we go, Randy Orton and Bram, Evolution. Two-thirds of Evolution, Batista not booked tonight. For the reasons of Bram against this team, who he's now a bit late finding out about. There they are. That is a fancy leopard on the side. It's the Great Khali all over again. You're a bit late finding out about who it was. He's right there. Look at his leopards, paying homage to the great, great Khali.
The great, great.
So, yes, this match gets underway.
I just want to be ready for when you ask me what.
Alright then. I'm now not going to ask you the match card until, like, the end of the show. Just to annoy you.
Okay, I got it.
Alright, so as Justin Roberts raps Enzo Amore's song, let's get ready for the tag team action. And what's the match card?
The match card. God, I don't know what the order of this is.
Yeah, well done.
I just have a random order here. Please tell me.
Just guess.
I'm paused. Okay. I know one match is a fatal four-way between.
That's definitely Ambrose, not next. Hardy.
No, that's like fourth match of the night.
Correct. Sure. Correct. Very well. Very well done.
Fifth match of the night. I know fifth match of the night.
Yes. Yes.
After this, I believe is Bobby Fish versus Alex Shelley.
Correct.
After that.
You're missing out.
Did you book a match yourself or something?
No, it's there. It took me quite a while to find it as well, but it's definitely there. Undertaker.
Oh, okay. After that is Undertaker versus Edge.
There we go.
After that is a fatal four-way between Austin Aries, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Dean Ambrose, and Matt Hardy.
Correct.
The main event is Cody Rhodes versus The Rock.
There we go. Because The Rock rolled up Curtis Axel on Velocity. What a chance he's got. Each of these competitors is looking for the back in the ring.
I wanted to do something different. I want those four to be in a pinnacle. So I was like, why don't you just give Rock a
He's exposing the business over here. Meanwhile, Randy Orton is in the middle of decimating Colin Cassidy, looking for the Vintage Orton. Vintage Orton.
The hell? Do you like the way around? I'm sorry, I haven't played a game. I can't believe
everything that's transpiring. Yeah, he does that now. It's been so
physical. He is that.
Yeah.
I'm so used to like the 2K15 way.
I like it. It sucks. My favorite one was WWE 13 with WWE 12 with Ray. You couldn't hurricanrana into the ropes. You had to go up to the ropes, then press the right stick in such an angle. Oh shit! Meanwhile, Bram with the Bright Side of Suffering. That's a stupid name.
That sounds like really.
It's such a stupid name. Oh, great work by Orton there to stop Enzo Amore. Good me, the three out of the four people in this match are wearing an assortment of red, white, and black in their,
the pants.
Yeah, that's the one. Randy Orton it off the hot tag, Michael. Oh, well. There you are getting jobbed. And kick to the area. RKO.
RKO.
What a match. Had the length of Orton and Ryder's match on Velocity. There you go. Randy Orton and Bram win. What an amazing match. I'd rate that one high. Wouldn't you? Wasn't it a spectacular?
Randy Orton is like running through the roster. Who's that? walks out, RKO someone, boom.
Well, I wouldn't say walks out, I'd say strolls at an extremely slow pace to the ring, then RKO someone and then just gets out of the ring. There you go, Evolution getting the win with their very similar trunks. But now let's move on from something that happened last week, which was very shocking, when the Motor City Machine Guns pinned Red Dragon. Tonight, yes, we watch Alex Shelley take on Bobby Fish. If you can notice, I actually, two things. One, didn't realize I hadn't set him his theme. And two, because I hadn't set his theme, I hadn't changed his entrance. So he's going to take his time to the ring. So yes, anyway, what did you think about last week while he takes an ice age to get to the ring? Of Motor City Machine Guns pinning Red Dragon.
I thought it was shocking. When I booked it, I did not think that they were actually the ring.
It was a shock. I was like, happening.
I was like, when I booked it, I was just like, okay, just put a team in there that I think we'll have a good match, but I think we'll lose. And no, they actually proved me wrong and I actually went. So now, looking at it, they can keep up this thing of beating or pinning these guys. You gotta think they're gonna get a tag team title shots.
I would say so. I think after being away for months and then coming back and defeating the WWE Tag Team Champions, who have been one of the most dominant teams on SmackDown, they did a pretty good job. Accompanied by
Kyle. Oh, Fish actually too.
I know. Look at him. He's keeping a good shape. And of course, Bobby Fish.
What the hell?
Come on. What are you going to say?
It's another phrase.
Oh, okay.
Well, I actually want to say something, actually, about this team. I think this team has been very overlooked because of the way, you know, the Shield were tag champs for forever, for so long. And then, you know, you don't think any team could really duplicate that. But these guys are actually doing a really good job of keeping the tag division on the map.
And, of course, when they went out into their singles areas, it's really been Bobby Fish who went into the singles areas. His first singles match, okay, their first tag match, they beat Evolution and become number one contenders. Bobby Fish's first singles match, he beats Austin Aries. We're in the
feeling out process here. It's funny because he's got like the same kind of entrance as Aries.
Yeah, that was actually it was like one entrance, out comes Austin Aries, does the same entrance. It was just copy and paste. But
he beats Austin Aries, who beat the longest reigning world champion on SmackDown history, I believe. And the two-time world champion. In the form of Chris Owens.
Hang on. Oh, Edge.
What?
That's right. Were you on about Edge?
No, I was saying that Fish beat the longest reigning, or beat the guy who beat the longest reigning world champion and beat a two-time world champion in his first singles match. And that's pretty impressive.
He beat a man who main evented WrestleMania. I mean, you know.
Pretty much, yeah.
There's
only four men in history that have main evented WrestleMania.
And one of them is Magnus.
One of them is Joe. The
other one is Punk and Aries. So they like one person. So who do you got in this match? Who's gonna get the win? It's a safe bet.
It is a safe bet. We don't know though, because when you think about it, Shelly can come out of nowhere and just upset again.
Oh yeah.
And that would be insane. But the safe bet is
Bobby Aries is going to win this one.
Oh, you Fish. Yes, the my pick is Fish, definitely.
All right. Okay, I will, right now, I'm not going to pick someone because I don't feel like I want to. But Bobby Fish is easily the safe pick. Because, you know, he's got the more experience. Definitely on the SmackDown brand, anyway.
Look at that shiny piece.
Very kick-based offense by Bobby Fish, and he's looking to put it away. Chris Sabin, however, on the apron. I mean, this is that was definitely a three count. Just saying.
Five.
Oh yeah, three and a half, man. He needs five. Really focusing on the head is Bobby Fish been throughout this entire match. The referee still talking to Chris Sabin. What's this move called? I forgot it.
Oh, it's a guillotine. It's a guillotine. It's a guillotine netlock or a front netlock, and he tapped.
Wow.
It's a guillotine. That's what I call it. It's a guillotine.
That was quick.
That was sudden. That was sudden. He just locked it in.
That was just like when Bobby Fish hits the fish hook. Just bam, hits it, and it's over. It's that was a very quick dispatch of Alex Shelley. Poor Shelley.
Well, still got that win over the tag match, so maybe that will get him somewhere. But Bobby Fish continues to be a singles dominating the singles.
I predict good things possibly in the future, Bobby Fish. Right now we go this man with a theme that I changed last week. There was no commentary because ill and stuff. But yes, Undertaker has got his old theme back, which is
very
good. Very good.
It's very, unfortunately, it's very borderline. It's very borderline copyright too.
We moved away from the borderline copyright one. We are in the Attitude Era one.
Oh, cool.
Unfortunately, it's quite a shit.
So is it Ministry?
Yes. Just he's not talking laughing at the beginning.
Oh, good.
Just fine.
They'd be 13 then.
Yeah. I don't remember playing any of these with him, but there we go.
I was down on I played it.
That explains why I knew. What did Undertaker do last week? Oh yeah, he had a very good match with Austin Aries. That was the one. Fortunately, though,
right, and he lost Aries, but he still had a really good performance.
He could have won it. He really could have. But maybe he can do the same. Maybe he can get the win tonight against Edge, who won two matches in a row. I don't think he's done that for about a year. Edge beating Mr. Anderson on the debut edition of Velocity, and then beating Christian last week, former Intercontinental Champion.
When I booked it, I was thinking Christian was going to win.
Exposure in the business!
We already know from ECW.
Yeah.
Zero card, I don't book. And we book Velocity together for
Christian. Yeah, sometimes.
We did the last one. And we're going to be putting out soon.
Are you trying to say we're pre-taped? This is live, Pam.
But again, we write the cards like it's in.
This is live, Pam.
Luke and Edge.
Can he...
Runs in the ring.
Can he get a win against former WWE champion? I mean, you know, this is a former WWE champion and a two-time World Heavyweight champion locking horns in the middle of SmackDown. Times have not been good for both men, but it's been definitely much worse for Edge than it has been Taker.
I think Taker is just on the cusp of coming back. He just came back, like, what, 4 weeks ago?
Something like that. Yes.
Yeah, he just came back and got in the Money in the Bank match.
Yes.
And that's when I came back.
It's 2 weeks removed. It's 2 weeks removed from Money in the Bank. Yeah, 4 weeks ago.
Yeah, okay, cool.
And I can't remember, who did he beat? The Rock. The Rock,
who beat Orton then? Someone beat Orton for the shot. Or is it
Mr. Dean? Mr. Money in the Bank.
He just came out.
There's Dean Ambrose. There goes Nambus. His entrance is just passing out. Yeah. Oh, God. Speaking of Dean Ambrose, he may need to overcome a problem, a little bit of a curse for the Money in the Bank, for the two other Money in the Bank holders. Because on Raw, Brock Lesnar lost, and on ECW, Michael Bennett lost.
Hey!
So, Dean Ambrose needs a win.
He needs to win, because... Oh shit, that's like the first time in universe history that we've had a Money in the Bank on every brand.
You swear this is scripted.
And we're going back between the ropes.
Meanwhile,
this is like the first time that we've had a Money in the Bank in every brand. I don't even know how. Oh, Lesnar beat Wyatt. That's fine.
He was just like, whoa, high, F5, done.
Whoa, high. Whoa, high.
That's his new entrance theme.
Anyway,
Hogan dropping the leg, brother. I love the two same moves we've seen. There's been neck breakers and DDTs.
And a belly to belly.
That's a DDT in my books. That was a neck breaker. So, you think, judging by what you said before the match started, I'm going to assume you've got Undertaker win this match.
I do have Undertaker.
A swift kick. That's a...
I don't know. I mean, Edge's been on a roll, but he's been defeating people who are not in the main event. Taker has been losing to people who are, like, in the main event scene.
Mm-hmm.
So, but he's been putting on good performances, so I do see when the worlds collide kind of thing.
He also murdered Dean Ambrose, so he's got that going for him.
Yeah.
He killed Dean Ambrose for a solid 2 minutes or something like that.
He almost beat Aries last week, as we said.
And
so it's definitely like, I would say, and he had a good performance. Oh, there's a DDT. He had a good performance in the Money in the Bank, definitely.
I mean, he didn't fall off every ladder, which is good for him.
But he still didn't win. I mean, the guy who did fall off every ladder won.
just get lucky sometimes. What an impact from that kick! Edge is actually... He probably is. I mean, well, we saw on SmackDown, he wasn't in the best condition when he lost the triple threat. Shockingly, you know. We had Cody Rhodes. We had...
Cody Rhodes didn't even win it. It was like Austin who won it, wasn't it?
Stone Cold was actually the one who won it. And he pinned both men as well. He stunned both of them, I believe. She's, you know.
So I would think, if Austin wins the four-way...
Uh-oh!
I would say...
Uh-oh!
Chokeslam!
This time not off a ladder.
Okay. But I would say...
Hang on, is this all Shiro?
One, two! No. I would say if Austin wins a Fatal 4-Way, I would say he's number one contender.
So if Austin wins his Fatal 4-Way, he's going to be number one contender?
That's what I think.
Okay. What's this move called? The Edger...
Oh my god, it's like the Educator.
What's not the... Oh yeah. He's got so many stupid moves.
So many Edge. It's not Edge. Oh
my...
Holy shit!
Wow. Tombstone Piledriver. I think this is it. One, two, three. Taker wins!
Wow, I think I've been right about every picture.
That was sudden.
That was insane. I did not see that coming.
Undertaker with a...
Important victory.
Yes. I was going to say with the... What? Maneuver. That was just sudden. I don't know if Edge was going for the spear or something, but
yeah, he just got caught in midair. It was
definitely reversed.
God, that was really Nazi. I did not think that was gonna happen.
So I wonder what this means for the future of Undertaker now. That was a very very good win. We'll see what the broadcast partner thinks when we're off the air. We don't want any spoilers now. We've gotta keep him interested, keep him coming back. Let's move on. To the Fatal 4-Way.
No, I actually have no idea what to do with the next one. But it will definitely be on the card. That's all I know. Anyway, this is awesome. From Victoria, Texas, weighing
252 pounds. Austin! Last week won a triple threat match where he pinned Mr. Money in the Bank and the World Heavyweight Champion. He's got a lot riding on him this week.
I would say, I'm shocked he's not in the main event in life.
But if he wins Hugh, he is number one contender. As we just said.
That's definitely true.
So does that mean
he gets a shot at Cody Rhodes?
because, you know, the only one in this match who technically eligible to become number contender is Austin Aries, as he is right here. If Austin Aries wins, is he number one contender?
I would say so, since he beat Taker last week. He has some momentum. I would say he needs to pin Austin to...
Well, this is just some WCW shit now. He has to pin Austin to become the number one contender.
I would suggest that he needs to pin Austin.
But if he just Austin wins, if he just wins in general, you know, he's a former two-time
wins,
world champion.
I would say if he wins, I'd say him and Austin need a match.
Oh, okay.
I would say if Austin wins, he's on such a roll that he just automatically gets a main contendership. But I still think that Austin and Aries should have a match.
Bit of Austin on Austin on action.
Yeah.
And here comes Mr. Money in the Bank.
From Cincinnati, Ohio. Here's someone who's a wild card.
Probably destroyed still. I mean, it was
actually
almost...
I don't know. I think Hardy is a wild card in this because he just won that six man last week.
He was almost, you know, Dean Ambrose almost dead.
Ambrose has been through so much shit over the past few weeks.
Despite that, 2 weeks ago, still beat Austin Aries, which was, you know, relatively well done.
Big! That was big! That
another,
was big.
Another chapter in the little rivalry. You know, that was nice to see from so many months ago, but Dean Ambrose came out the winner last week. Well, he didn't come out the winner, and this week, can he be the only Mr. Money in the Bank to win?
That would be a big thing. Is this elimination? Yeah, I have a match.
Yeah. Or is the number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship going to take you home?
Holy crap. The number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship beats three guys who are pretty much top contenders for a world title? That's insane.
Yeah. If he can beat former world champion, Mr. Money in the Bank, I think Matt Hardy has kind of shown that, yeah, I'm the best superstar ever. Just gotta put it out there, you know. He pretty much is. He still has two longest reigns. For now. It might become one.
It's
relatively
weird
soon
that he's not on Raw anymore. Just saying. But it just feels weird because he dominated Raw.
Yeah, he did.
He dominated Raw. He had the longest world title and the longest mid-card title reign that we've ever seen.
It's amazing.
Who knew? And his brother doesn't do absolutely anything. He never seemed to book. He like never gets booked. I never book him.
he had a match with Hardy at WrestleMania and lost to a kick. What more do I need to say? You know.
I don't think he's been the same.
No,
but
he probably
bounced back from a jawbreaker. So.
Yeah, he bounced back. And he bounced back from an awful 2014 as well.
Even though it's every man and he's had great 2015.
Yeah. Okay, we've already got to give a
team
shot.
Even though he wasn't booked at WrestleMania.
Well, you know, there's only room for so many people. Oh my god, Dean Ambrose with strength.
But he came back. He came back after that. And just started winning matches.
Oh yeah. And before you knew it, bam, world champion.
Yeah, he knows how he's going to keep it, but he probably... The way he's going, I think we booked for SummerSlam, definitely.
What do you think he's going to defend past Vengeance?
I don't know, it depends who he faces. And the two men that are fighting on that little corner right now are the two men that are the top contenders in my eyes. To face Cody Rhodes.
Austin Aries, who is, you know, wanting a rematch to join CM Punk for three world championships.
Yes.
And then we've got Stone Cold Steve Austin, who...
Was a former world champion.
And has, and of course, has also been involved in a feud with CM Punk.
And has had the best summer feud we've probably ever seen.
Oh, yeah. Well, we've only had one summer feud, so. Technically.
Technically, well, I think it's still the best feud of the summer that we had, like, overall, like, all brands.
I don't know. Matt Hardy episode 100 was a pretty good feud. he did go far.
Wait,
with it.
This is the guy he lost.
We got the finals all over again.
Yeah, we got the finals and we got Austin Aries versus Dean Ambrose, which is like February all over again.
Got an old rivalry and episode 100.
Yeah.
We cannot let the past go.
We can't. But there's no CM Punk, so we can't. We kind of can.
You definitely can. So,
no CM Punk.
Oh, okay. What is? Whoa, my.
Whoa! Look at that rolling neck breaker.
That was very nice. Oh, nice clothesline there by Stone Cold. Awesome. Totally connecting with Matt Hardy.
Totally. Oh, look at that neck break.
Great, I want more neck breakers. That's what we said before we went out for the show. Give me more neck breakers in every match. The Ambrose now being a lunatic and choking. The laugh. And Matt Hardy. Okay, no, now they. Oh, okay, now we're all going to go in the corner. Backstab! That was just what Dean Ambrose needs, more pain on his back. I think he'll love that.
One!
Not even a one. Matt Hardy is too much of a superstar to not be, you know, not going to even get a one count against him. Austin Aries getting back up to his feet. And falls back on his ass. And gets back up to his feet.
Was that like a cartwheel?
I thought it was a wheelbarrow. Whatever.
Yeah, that's what it is. Well.
Filters. Oh. Twist of fate.
Twist of fate.
Yeah.
Twisting neck breaker.
More neck breakers. One. Two.
Two.
Austin Aries now confused by what he's supposed to do.
Oh,
there we go. Back in action. Nope, never mind.
Okay.
Encountered.
You know, he should have, because he had the suplex backbreaker. You know, wait, what the hell?
He's working the arm?
I'm so confused. What is going on between these two?
Gotta work the arm. Yes!
Another
more
neck
breakers. Yes, I said, Matt Hardy, really work the arm.
God, just working the arm.
Oh, elbow. No.
Ah!
And
look at that kick.
Oh, wait a minute. Uh-oh. Austin Aries.
Brainbuster.
Appa dappa brainbuster.
Got it. That's it for Ambrose.
One. Two.
Two.
No.
Three. No.
Oh, I don't know what Austin
wait,
just did.
Hardy.
He's pinning Hardy.
One.
Nope, never mind. He's not. Do you mind doing King of the Mountain over there? That's Jeff Jarrett's gimmick. Guillotine choke. Matt Hardy really is like, I gotta get this guillotine choke over.
Yeah, because he's a fish.
Submission expert Matt Hardy.
Like this boy fish.
Yeah. Again!
Twisting neck breaker.
Twist
of fate. Second one. Oh, that might be.
Dean Ambrose, dirty deeds.
That's a
two.
Deeds.
What?
Three. No! No, no, you kicked out a two.
What?
Ares is out. No, he's not. What the hell? Holy shit.
We're not. Apparently, the.
Apparently, we can't have an elimination.
Nope.
Oh, this match is going to last forever. One. Zero.
DDT.
Austin needs a stunner. Soon. He needs to pull off a stunner soon.
Oh, this is just back and forth. This is just. No one's allowed to win, apparently. Too much riding on it.
Good God.
Matt Hardy, back up to his feet.
The same fight. I think we've been having the same four people fight.
Oh, yeah. Matt Hardy with a clothesline.
Oh!
And another. And off the ropes.
And a heel kick.
No!
No!
He missed it. He missed a drop kick. Suplex by Austin Aries in the corner. Oh, here we go. Austin knocking the ref on his ass.
Oh,
middle
God.
Fingers. Elbow. Aries looking for his signature Death Valley Driver.
That's Death Valley Driver by Aries.
Austin! Stunner!
Stunner! Stunner!
Dean Ambrose eliminated
from his
Death Valley Driver. Hardy after the stunner.
One, two.
Oh boy!
Oh, this is the final two. This is definitely number one contenders match right here.
It's now a number one contenders match. There you go, you hear it here first.
This is definitely the top two guys right here.
Abdominal stretch.
Is he gonna finish him with an abdominal stretch? That'd be so funny. Is he actually gonna do it? Oh my God! He finished him with an abdominal stretch. Well,
what a.
Austin has proved that he is number one contender in my eyes.
The people outside apparently not happy. Oh, okay, Matt Hardy's back.
Matt Hardy has shook his
head. Probably because they beat the shit out of each other for most of this match. There we go. An abdominal stretch that actually won Randy, no, Edge the World Championship over a year ago. The dominant abdominal stretch. Now then, let's move on to our main event. It's The Rock. versus Cody Rhodes.
Oh, I still remember.
Yeah.
One of the first shows I ever did, I started talking about Rock's like old. Like, oh, he's the enemy champion in the past.
I think I squashed that.
Yes. I was like a six-man tag, and I started talking about Rock's like old shit, like before not even universe shit, just like real shit.
I was just like, what's he going on about? What is he talking? I don't remember The Rock went main eventing WrestleMania. All I remember is him winning the Hardcore Championship at WrestleMania. That's actually Rock's career at WrestleMania.
Just winning the Hardcore title.
That's it.
That's it. That's the only WrestleMania he's ever been on, and that's the only WrestleMania he'll ever be on.
Essentially. We don't know yet. We don't. But, what can The Rock do tonight against Cody Rhodes?
Oh, God. This is going to be insane, because I really...
Hang on a minute!
What the hell? It's Drew McIntyre!
Drew?
From the Next Big Things.
Why is it...
He wants a title shot.
Everyone wants a title shot. But the Next Big Things have been silent for a number of weeks. And Drew McIntyre just attacked the world champion. Was he sent out by Paul Heyman? We don't know. I mean, he could have been. But
hey, they've been silent for weeks except for Benjamin, because Benjamin was in the six-man for last week.
McIntyre and MVP and Titus haven't been around for some time, and well, I mean, that's one way to, you know, say you're still around, is to attack the world champion before his match. Well, that put Rhodes off his game, though.
I don't know, Rhodes has been on a roll, I've heard.
Well, he's one for one.
Okay.
Come on, now.
He's not, like, on a roll. He's just, like, here. Well, what did he win? Because I know he lost a triple threat.
He won the world title. I think you might want to remember that one. He beat Austin, funnily enough. No, he didn't. He beat Joe. Beat Joe, that's who he beat.
Crap, I haven't seen Joe in books since.
I know. He's going to get a penis tattoo on his face. Remember that gimmick?
Yes.
Going to go get that. You're like EWR on this thing, the auto booker. I want you to book these 10 people, no more, just these 10. what will happen to The Rock if The Rock can beat Cody Rhodes?
The Rock can beat Cody Rhodes? Good God, he's getting the match with Austin.
Oh, okay, Austin. Is it a number one contenders match, or is it if Rock beats Austin, it's a triple threat match?
I would say a triple threat match in a way, because I don't want to take away Austin's shot, because he's been winning so much that I don't think one loss should kill his opportunity.
Alright then. Oh, Rock might actually win it here! Sneaky
one!
That was the most...
If Rock wins, it'd be like the biggest upset on SmackDown in a while, in my opinion.
Oh yeah, because Cody Rhodes in his pay-per-view. We'll go along with that.
No, but Cody Rhodes... Well, I mean, Cody Rhodes got the biggest upset in SmackDown history, in my opinion. Definitely. Beating Austin Aries.
No, I can't...
And Austin Aries hasn't really been the same since. But Austin Aries has had some good matches since.
He hasn't won since losing his title.
He has won one match. He would be Taker. But
shit, and he did. Too many shows.
Too many shows. Not enough.
Too much remembering stuff.
Too many people to book.
Exactly. God. Oh, God. Here we go. Cody Rhodes. Alabama Slam.
Like, Austin when I'm booking people. Just saying.
That's why, yeah. Cody Rhodes trying to put this one away after the Alabama Slam. Two. Two. Oh, catches the boot. Nziguri. That was spectacular.
That was
dashing.
That was like a
spinning. see what I did there? But, I mean, I'm pretty sure that's his gimmick right now, and it is the dashing arrow of SmackDown under Cody Rhodes.
Oh, that works. That works very well.
Big clothesline down by Rhodes. Rhodes inviting Rock up. He's trying to put this one away. Cody Rhodes.
Crossroads.
Crossroads.
Got it.
Is this it?
That's it.
One, two, no.
No! Oh my God. Oh my
Rock
God.
With a roll up.
One, two.
Two. It's getting close now.
I know, I'm scared. I really
nice
thought
uppercut.
Hey, Goldust.
I'm pretty sure he's on the roster.
He is.
Yeah. Really? Raise my arm. Yeah. Book him.
Wait, is he on SmackDown?
I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
He's been booked in he hasn't been booked in over a year, I'll say that. Pay no attention to that, I was technical with difficulties.
Oh,
and now he's busted open. Busted open the Rock. And now off the ropes, looking for the disaster kick.
Hits
it.
Why is it on the arm? I never understood that.
One, pin, two, three. Cody Rhodes is the winner. I might have given him a concussion to the arm. You never know. Cody Rhodes is the winner. And oh, no. That's not a good sight.
Oh, it's the next big thing. They want the belt.
I wasn't concerning Drew McIntyre as much. Brock Lesnar was by Drew McIntyre's side.
Was it like Titus O'Neil?
Mr. Money in the Bank, Brock Lesnar.
That can cash in on any brand, Brock Lesnar.
Uh-oh. That may mean bad things for Rhodes. So he's got the next big things to worry about, and he's got Stone Cold Steve Austin at Vengeance.
Yep.
Rhodes is going to be in tough times.
Yes, he is.
It's going to be a difficult time. It's going to be a difficult road for Rhodes.
On the road of Cody.
Roads.